Vittorio De Sica captured a specific kind of Italian energy. He was a neorealist at heart and the prototypical Neapolitan gentleman. De Sica examined life's small victories and defeats, along with how social conditions affect his character's train of thought. To me, the great-grandson of an Italian immigrant, his characters feel like distant relatives, especially those portrayed by Sophia, Loren, and Marcello Mastroianni. De Sica's post-war neorealist films featured non-professional actors, non-studio settings, and bleak narratives, but they were ultimately about the quest for personal freedom under difficult circumstances. Even though De Sica would move away from a strict definition of Italian neorealism,
Inglese, Americano, Svizzere,
core concepts of the movement still drove the collective narratives for De Sica's later films, like 1963's Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow. Bedroom chemistry, bedroom drama. De Sica communicates a sense of community and the characters' unbreakable bonds, their inner drive, and ability to overcome the odds.
Oh, Madonna me.
Through all of De Sica's collaborations with Sophia Loren and Marcello Mastroianni during this time, the bedroom is a recurring theme, as the characters experience pleasure and pain, a constant paradox. Incidentally, they revert to Catholicism for a distraction from reality, and they're constantly being judged. De Sica identifies the sacred and profane while noting that appearances can be deceiving. The same concepts apply to De Sica's follow-up film, Marriage, Italian Style. Mastroianni plays a wealthy Neapolitan named Domenico, and Loren plays a former prostitute with a big secret. Actually, three secrets. Again, the conflict stems from the bedroom. If you've ever been to Napoli, then you surely understand the city's beautiful chaos, that sense of excitement, danger, and undeniable culture. This time around, De Sica addresses traditional Neapolitan values, but he also pinpoints the spectacle that emerges from deceptive behavior. In this community, everyone knows what's going on. Still, it's the unbreakable bonds that prevail. With Sunflower, released in 1970, De Sica takes a stripped-down approach to underline similar narrative themes. Hoping to avoid a World War II separation, Mastroianni and Loren's characters fake bedroom drama, but their plan fails, and they ultimately make separate journeys to Russia for entirely different reasons. In this film, the bedroom visuals become significantly more impactful. The stakes are higher. It's more about long-term survival rather than momentary confusion. Meaning, De Sica's vibrant Neapolitan narratives mostly examine day-to-day conflict and how spontaneous or even calculated decisions affect the characters and their community. In Sunflower, De Sica takes a deeper look at what it means to be accountable over an extended period of time. And he once again returns to a bedroom scene full of the same thematic concepts to emphasize his character's unbreakable bond. In a way, De Sica's characters live and die each day, but they embrace their struggles and survive thanks to love, community, and their own self-determination, Italian style.